Fisher back again. Not yet. Max Fisher back again to show you and comment on a match between Hugo Patino and Jae Cho. Mr. Patino has won the break. The fact that Mr. Patino missed that his break shot is very unusual. That's three for Mr. Cho, who's a current national champion, USBA national champion, an outstanding player. Hugo Patino is a two-time national champion. So you can see what kind of a match we have in store for you here. Score five for Mr. Cho. Nice double the rail shot for Mr. Patino. He's on board. Live streaming for the Invitational Champion of Champions is provided by MI Billiards, Love to Use Streams. Special thanks to Steve Elzinga. This event is promoted by Professor Cue Ball, better than, and Paul Frankel, in case anybody doesn't know who that is, and Alan Hopkins Productions. They're presenting the Invitational Champion of Champions. Here in Valley Forge, King of Prussia, Valley Forge Convention Center. Top of the fourth inning, the score is 7-2, favor Mr. Cho. Beautiful shot by Mr. Patino. Hugo at one time had a high run of 31. Can you imagine 31? How long it would take to make 31?
Thank you.
twice across for Hugo. Very well done. This level of player is very good on a twice across. Beautiful drop in the corner. Looks like it's another cross table shot, probably three cushions. Very precise, Mr. Cho. Beautiful bank. Plus two bank. Great system to know. Comes in handy a lot. Look, we're going to go cross table, long rail, short rail, and ball. Wow. Never used a short rail at all in that shot. He had three long rails. Very interesting. Reverse English Tiki, very nicely done. He's shown us a nice variety of shots here. Difficult hit to make when you're frozen on the rail. Go score is 9-8 at the end of the sixth inning, favor Mr. Cho. Appears to me, just my own opinion, that they seem to be a little confused by the way this table's playing. It does take much English at all off the third rail. And if you hit the balls a little too hard, the angle distorts greatly. Then again, what do I know? They're playing and I'm talking. Everything's still tied at 9-9. One thing is sure, that Hugo Patino is not leaving anything for Mr. Cho to get started with. And I guess the same can be said for Mr. Cho. Four straight open innings for Mr. Cho, highly unusual. Long rail, short rail. No, short rail. He's going to play it out of the corner. too. Very good. He got a little slide there, which is good. Good to see. Well, that's a beauty. Beautiful shot. I wonder whether they could get around the table twice here. I don't think he'll try to do it. But I think the tables have enough speed to do it, and he's got enough stroke. Very nice shot. Very, very good there. Tough angle to get. Finally, it looks like a little opening here. Go. Boy, we're right in sync. Friend out in Vallejo, California, Khalil Diab, and whenever he would make a real good hit, it would just miss. He would say, "Beautiful hit, now please sit." And he would always get a lot of laughs, especially when you're just playing for fun. I don't think it would here. shot. Dead English ball. Techie. Jae Cho plays Techie very, very well. Actually, from what I've seen in the past, most Korean players do play cushion first or two cushion first shots extremely well. That's the fourth one on this run. Got a mini run here, hoping to make it into a maxi. Oh boy, he almost let that one get away. That's six. This one requires a little bit of work. Wonderful shot, wonderful control of the cue ball. I think he could probably drop this in the corner. Maybe not. That's what he's going to try to do. Gee whiz. Boy, that's hard to take. Run a seven. Well done. Seven and three quarters, seven eighths, whatever. Sounds like a hat size, but it still comes to seven. Hugo's answering back. That's three. terrific. He's working on negating Cho's seven. He's got four of it back. See what happens here. He's got a decent shot. I think Hugo's pleased to catch the edge of that. It looked like he might miss it. Yes, he did get an edge of that. Oh, he's got the seven right back. Interesting game. Either they were both having open frames or they're both making nice runs. Bottom of the 14th inning. 118 in the bottom of the 15th inning. Nice touch.
Such a long walk, I forget.
Hugo should have something to work with here. I assume he's going to play at five rails or four or five rails here. And what will we do here? Will we try to go around the table or will he try to drop that in? I know what he tried to do, it just didn't work out. These two are such good players that you rarely have a chance to second guess them. Hasn't been an easy game for either one of them to play. There's not a lot of shots coming up. That's two in this inning, and we're in the 19th inning here. I guess he needs to cut this shot, hit it thin. Beautiful. I didn't leave anything.
Running out of food. Huh? I'm running out of food. Mason never did come back with that drink, that rat bastard.
Rat bastard, that's a good thing. Yeah, I think, you know, in the beginning of the game, I accidentally put one extra one on Hugo's and took it off immediately. And then Mr. Cho ran a seven, and he said eight. And I think he thinks that I made a mistake. Because when Hugo ran a 7, and I put, you know, I put the score up, he asked Hugo, how many did you make? Hey, man, I made a mistake at the beginning. That doesn't mean I'm
going to
make a mistake all the way through.
No, our score's been jogging all the way along here.
Everything's right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I wanted to make sure I didn't make a mistake because I might have, as possible.
It's easy to hit the wrong button.
Yep, that's all I do.
And it's easy to fall asleep a little bit during this, too.
Yeah, I don't know how you're doing this. I mean, you.
I'm not talking so much this game. I mean, there's really not much to talk about. There's a lot of open innings. And they're not getting much to shoot at.
No.
But this is our last game.
I think he thinks that I'm asleep at the wheel, and I'm not really. I might look like I'm sleeping.
Or maybe you don't like him, right?
Actually, I do like him. He's
good.
A nice guy.
Good. He is a nice guy.
I picked him up at the airport and carted him around when he came to Detroit, and I like the guy. He's mild mannered, and he's got a beautiful stroke.
How is his English? Can he communicate?
It looks like he's picked up a little bit. But
when I first met him,
you know, his sister speaks really good English. She's been listening for 25 years.
That should help him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's living with her, so. And they work together,
an open inning for Hugo. They're back from their break. I think he's going to try to drop this in, just like a ticky, I think. Nice effort. Been an awful lot of open innings in this game for players of this caliber. And 8 of them for Hugo Patino, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 12 from Jae Cho. Thank you.
26-20 into the bottom of the 21st inning. Very nice bank. Once again, the leave requires quite a bit of work here. I hit it thin and go around the table. And I think he deserved better than that. It's a terrific hit. I don't know if it's going to make or not. No, it's not. Well, he finally broke his string of open innings, which I'm glad to see. And then again, he left the balls. He's down one end of the pier, and the balls are down the other end. Very nice hit. Beautiful hit. Thank you. Billiards, too. Boy, what a marvelous effort that was. It was just a super try. This game just refuses to open up except for these inning where they each had seven. Other than that, there's nothing much happening in this game. That's a two for Mr. Cho. He's in his 27th inning. -25 favor Mr. Patino. is one for Hugo, and a nice looking shot for the next one. Not sure what he's going to do here. He's going to go cross table, but he went around that way. Well, I told you I wasn't sure. In the 29 innings, Mr. Patino's got 32, Mr. Cho's got 26. There's just too many of these shots to start off an inning with. Shots like this where you're seeing one ball and you got an awful lot of open space around. I got 32. Okay with me. I got the innings right. What's the other guy? What's the other score? 26. terrific. Very good. He's the guy that owns the pool room for Barry Works. Yeah. If Mr. Cho's going to get back into this game, he's got to do it pretty quick. For your viewers, don't forget Saturday night at 9 o'clock. Tune in, and there's a trick shot show done by Miguel Torres, who's very good. Saturday night at 9 o'clock. Needed to get that edge and didn't get it. He didn't leave him Hugo with much to shoot at, but that's been happening the whole game between the two of them. Table reversed for the bank. Tough angle to judge. Only got it that way. think Hugo's playing for two. Three playing for one. This is a game where Mr. Cho never really got started except for the run of seven he had, which was quickly answered by a seven right back. That's the game. And just to say again that that was 40-29 in 32 innings. There was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 innings that were open for Mr. Cho, which is highly, highly irregular. One that'll never see that again. Max Fisher signing off till tomorrow at 11 o'clock.